What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 435 of making Songbringer. Today I'm working on the final boss. The last boss. This is mostly just mock-up art. I'm actually using the art from the last boss I worked on temporarily while I just work on behaviors today. So I will not be working on pixel art today. It's just mostly going to be programming, behaviors, scripting, getting this boss to kind of behave how I imagine this boss will be. Eventually this boss will kind of look like Satan, like a big devil. So yeah, one attack where he flies up into the sky and then slams back down on the ground really hard and causes like this explosion. So that's what I'm working on right now. I've been working on this all morning, actually, just kind of getting that going as it has so far. And I'm just working on the rest of it now. So welcome to the stream. And I hope all y'all are having a good day out there watching this on YouTube or whatever. Whatever you're doing, I hope you're enjoying it. What's up, Pedro? Welcome. So I need to show, there's something wrong with the AI every time it goes up in the air. Ori? Oh, Ori in the Blind Forest. I kind of have a love-hate relationship with this video game. I love its art. I love its video game. I love its story. But I hate how it punishes me so much. It's very difficult. I end up dying and dying and dying and dying. And it's like, I die so many times playing Ori and the Blind Forest. It's like, am I really enjoying myself at this point? Am I really enjoying dying this many times? And then sometimes you don't die, but you barely make it through a certain section with like one hit point. And then you're just like, okay, I should just die anyways now so I can go back and get some hit points. It is. It's because I suck. Because I'm not an amazing gamer, apparently. But yeah, so I love it and hate it. All right, so there's this bit here in AI system. I want to show the Z for the Z position for every, here it is. No, not there. Yeah, here it is. Cool. I want to show the Z position for every foe always. Yeah. You start working on Monday? Hey man, that's great. Where at? Oh, see, that's the problem. This boss just overshot zero. So its position went all the way down to like negative 32. Why is it so, why is this text so high above its head? You had 4 interviews in the same afternoon at the same company. They didn't let you go home without an offer? Wow. That's great. Dude, congratulations, Pedro. That's awesome news. What's up, Arcane? Yep, this is the final boss. It's IT consultancy. Sweet, man. That's really cool that they didn't let you go home without an offer. Boogie! What's up, Boogie? Oh, and sometimes they work with games? That's great. Yeah, I just started streaming. That's awesome, Pedro. You just randomly checked. Good call. You timed it perfectly. Yeah. When this boss does his drop, his mega super drop, he keeps overshooting by a bit. So what can I do to get this guy not overshoot? And secondly, I need to have his debug text a little more visible. It's too far above his head. And then when he's under the ground, you can't hit him. That's why that's happening. Thank you. Okay, let's start with the render component has a little bit of a function where it just sets a label above the entity's head. So for this entity, it's like not high enough. You're the modest of all the mods. Oh, here it is. Position Y is label, kit position Y plus. I can't be right. Oh, here it is. I think this is it. Is that an anchor point? Yeah, pause and then anchor. So this is pause. Oh, this is anchor. It's anchored in the middle. Huh. Maybe I'll just take this off. You're currently coding one website for a friend? If it goes right, you get work. Nice! Is it the new Facebook? Still, the logo is so far above his head. What is the problem here? I guess if I do vec2 halfway there, zero there. You just installed new fiber internet at home? Sweet. Oh my god, 100 up and down? God damn, that's awesome. Now his text is just gone. So weird. Those all look good though. Oh wait, no, there he is. Yeah, zero. No. Yeah. Wait. No, that was a zero for this thing. Where'd your text go? What's happened to his label? Trying to make that better right now is just too hard. I don't want to do it. Don't want to do it anymore. Okay, so I know that the boss is going through the ground by a little bit. I guess I need a way for a bot, like an enemy here in the behavior tree, the scripting. I need a way to set a position. That's actually really easy. I guess I would write it like this too. I'll go position Z 0. That's what I want to do. Let's write that. Let's write some code for that. Live strip tease. Oh my god.
The doorbell.
Oh my god, all you got was make it look good? No PSCs, no images, nothing. Not even any example websites like, hey, I kind of like the look of this website. Can you make it kind of look like that? Okay, so we're going to do set positions, kind of like set velocity. Behavior velocity. What? Oh, vector. There's if vector set movement vector. We want something just like this, but set position. Whoa, you changed the main design 3 times? Dang. I hope that wasn't too much effort. Set position, behavior, position, and I want to make sure I didn't actually do this already. I don't think I did. Behavior, position. That's just if position. Yeah, okay, cool. We're good. For the first time, we're writing a set position. Zuckerberg allegedly stole the idea for Facebook from the Winklevoss twins, who he worked for. I remember seeing that in that movie, The Social Network. So how did I do this? I did position Z zero. So if subtype equals K behavior. Hey, wow. Sometimes the Xcode's autocomplete just knows what I'm thinking already. I have no idea how. Subtypes behavior Z. E.position.pause.z. We're also going to set last pause. The final boss of the thing? Is this the old one? The girl? Yeah. Maybe. So this boss is going to have 2 phases, right? One phase where you fight him once, and then another phase. So maybe he does turn into a girl afterwards and then get really even bigger. I forgot all about that. That was a good idea. Thanks for reminding me, Boogie. Forgot all about that. What I liked about that boss design was that it was this, you had very, very small area where you could walk and just this tons of room for the boss. So it kind of like, it made it into more of a flying type feeling because that boss was flying. It's good to remember what I liked about that boss and to try and bring that into either this boss fight or the second phase of this boss fight. Like maybe the second phase of the boss fight, part of the ground just falls out of the way and then he just gets bigger. You fight him again, but this time he's huge. She's great dreadlocks. Yeah. She's kind of Medusa devil. I think this is going to be Flow Val 1. Let's see if that works. Oh. Thanks again for reminding me of that. Okay, the boss falls down from the sky. Hits right here. Flow Val 1 is 0, of course. So I'm going to change this to something so I can make sure that... Just confirm it's working. Like 0.05 or something. One step at a time. Songbringer is almost mostly content complete. You know, as soon as this boss is done and the tower is finished, the game will be mostly content complete. There will still be a lot of minor content to be added, but most of the major content for Songbringer will be finished as of the end of this week, or maybe the middle of next week. It's pretty exciting. I'm excited to have like most of the creative stuff done and to kind of focus more on making everything a little bit more detailed and everything a little bit more interesting and adding the other little smaller features that I've always wanted to put in. Jonah! What's up, Jonah? You like the proportions? Okay, so this is confirmed. Float valve 1, 0.05. Blam! Blam! Okay, now I can write this out for the other things too. I like it better like that. She gains some weight. Okay, so this is going to keep the boss from flying through the ground. As soon as the boss hits the ground, it just automatically sets its position. Times change. Final stretch of your dissertation due in 9 days. Oh, how you doing, man? How's it going? Well, how's the dissertation turning out? What are you working on? Are you on track? Hit her. Him. It's gonna be a him, but right now she's a her. Good. Still hit her. On the report part. Nice. Cool. That's fixed now. All right, next thing I want to work on is the little pentagram explosion thing. I want it to look more like a big explosion wave type thing. So I'm gonna try a different art take on that. This is what I just grabbed something from the internet as far as just to test it out. I want it to look more like a, first of all, more 3D. So let's start with that. Start with the circle. Let's get a gray background. Yeah, totally. Can I play it on Mac? Okay, so if I take this circle and put it down to make it more 3D. How tall is this? 360. Jonah, is it a link we can play online, or is it like a download And what platform? I'd love to try. I would love the honor of trying it out. Oh, it's Windows. Okay, well, I do have Windows. I can restart and all that. Let me save the link. And do you have a link already to the feedback survey? No worries, man. I can download things. Oh, you have a Mac one? Oh, great. Oh, it's nice. Hell yeah. Start downloading that right now. Nice. Right on, man. And, okay, I'm downloading it right now. I'll try it out after the stream. But so what about the feedback survey? Okay, let me just take this link too, just in case that I have any troubles with the Mac version. You're welcome, man. It's my honor. I already like the looks of the game. I can't wait to see it. To play it, I mean. Okay, so we got this position. What was I gonna do next? Oh yeah, the graphics. That's the problem with Burning Man. You come back so inspired, but you're also like, bleh. What was I doing? There's a button in the game? Man, you thought of everything. I'm sure you're gonna get an A. All right, so here's how it would look in a 3D perspective if that were like a circle on the ground at this game's perspective. And then I want to do some like, sort of like some shooting beams of, or like some light. So what's the easy way to do that? I mean, I can easily make one pixel going like that, but I want to do a lot of pixels like that. I don't think there's an easy way to do this in Photoshop. I basically just want to do a bunch of a faded light going from a gradient from white to transparent white and just have that actually follow the curve here. Well, if you can't think of an easy way to do it, you might as well do it the slow way. All right, we'll do this the slow way. So we'll do a square here, rectangle. Starting from white. I wish there was a quick way to do this because I'm not sure if this will turn out how I want it. But alas! Oh, I got it. I can do one side and then just flip it over. I'll make it a little quicker. At least Photoshop's not making a bunch of layers out of this. Just keep it all on one layer. The joy of game dev. Right. That's why I was racking my brains at first. I'm like, there's gotta be a simpler way to do this. Something that isn't gonna be this time consuming, but the joy here is that I'm almost finished. And then it will be even more joy if this actually looks right in the game. If it doesn't even look right, I'm like, shit, now I just gotta throw all that away. But that happens too a lot, right? What? Oh, yeah, wait, I did it right. Okay, cool. That's a nice little gradient. Gradient! Okay, and then the last thing is I want to make this inner circle bit. Oh shit. I gotta redo this inner circle. Damn it. All right, so it's 222 pixels tall. Select this, do a little layer via cut. Okay, cool. Now we do a little gradient. Shazzle. Wait a minute. I think I want to do a gradient. But with the circle bit, wait, why is it circle weird? Oh, okay, because of that. All right. Okay, so I want to do a gradient on this circle as well. We can do this with layer blending though. So I can turn off the fill opacity, make it invisible, and then do a gradient overlay and make it radial and do the right. There we go. Reverse that. Boom. There we got going from transparent to white. Let's move this transparency a bit. Whoops, not that. This. Yeah. So there's a little bit of a hole in the middle. Now I can take this, like. Do I rasterize it first? I think I have to rasterize this first. Yeah. And then just resize it down to 220. Whoa, did you see that? I automatically dragged it right to the perfect pixel, but then lost it. Lost it. Okay, there. Boom. Boom. It's kind of what I was imagining. All right, let's see if this thing even looks right. Export that. No. Not the render video. I got export with the regular. Hold on. I do this all the time. There's two different things I use it to export stuff. It's confusing. Pentagram. This used to be a pentagram. All right, let's see what it looks like. Did that just take 5 minutes or what? 5 whole minutes. 5 whole minutes. Can't believe it. Yeah, it kind of looked right. Now it's not beefy enough, though. Try with a oh, I know what could be wrong here. When it does that effect, explosion gram, it's using a scale ratio that doesn't need that anymore. Let's do scale ratio 1.0 because it's already got the scale built into it. I just need to make it feel beefier now. Start with adding a pentagram. What is this black pixel on top? Yeah, totally. So what's your page link, man? Pedro's like, no. Send us the link. Oh, there. It looked beefier, for sure. The center point is wrong. Let's slow down time next time he does it. Okay, slow down. Slow down. Oh, it actually does, but then it ends. Okay, it starts right, but then it ends wrong. Does it need to move upward? Arcane! Let's check it out. See how it looks. Nice. I'm thinking this looks really clean and good. Yeah. Ooh, look at that. You got your menu working already too? Sweet. Prague, I love this city. I love this city. Prague is amazing. I've been to Prague. I've been to Lake Bolaton. Hey, maybe you could use a little more on the bottom. You know how like most sites these days kind of have like a bottom footer section where they've got the links again, where you could be like, oh, hey, if you missed it on the rest of the page, here's their contact link. Anyways, and here's a link to the second page and the third page and stuff, you know? Other than that, it looks really, really clean and good. Fort you what? You got it, yeah. You had to send him that, huh? Justify text, so that's a good suggestion. Guess it, that's kind of a stylistic aesthetic suggestion, you know? Whatever you prefer there. I don't know. Is this helping? Footer larger than the whole site, I'll do that. Oh, footer larger than the whole site, right? That is funny how some sites do that. Yeah, it looks great. It looks really great. I guess maybe you could, if you really wanted to wow him, you could maybe add a little parallax to this top image. So as you're scrolling down, this it looks like it's parallaxing because this site is actually moving upwards a little bit more than the background is. I know that's technically a hard thing to do, and I've done it before on websites, and it's kind of a bitch, but like it does look really cool once you get it done. Good work, man. Good work. I hope he hires you. So the pentagram is like, oh, it could be how it's anchored. Yeah, it's anchored middle. This might be the problem. It's got an anchor set, anchor middle. So that means that, let's try out anchoring it on the bottom. See what happens. There you go. Now you got a reason to do parallax. We let you win. Okay, so that did properly anchor it to the middle, or to the... Yeah, but now it just needs to be positioned a little lower. Based on how big it is at the end. I'm not sure. Sprite.setPosition. Why? Sprite. Well, it's using pause. Okay, so we'll do pause.y plus, no, minus sprite.get content size dot height times a half times 7, I think. Might need to be less. Port you what? I could do this all night. Okay, so that's way too low. It's just like that. This is the WTF method, kids. Anybody's watching this and you're like, why is he just stumbling through this? It's because this is how I do it. This is how I code games. I try something, I try again. Because math doesn't always make sense to me. Because there's so many layers to math and video games. You've got this position, that entity's parent position, and then that entity's parent's position, and then, oh yeah, your whole screen has a certain position, and blah, 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 blah. It's too much stuff to actually understand. I don't even try and understand it. I just guess. I'm happy for your first and only accomplishment. So was it the max scale times a half again? Just guessing. WTF method. Scaling up. Yeah, it's getting bigger. So it starts with a certain scale. Starts with a scale of 0.125. And then it scales all the way up to 7.0. Slow down. Oh, that was weird. That time it definitely scaled upward. Oh, it's always gonna scale upward with the anchor like that. Ah, yeah, this isn't gonna work this way. Boo. Okay, so we gotta do anchor middle. I just gotta figure out why anchor middle was doing that weirdness. Why it would look like it was moving downwards, but that had to be some kind of optical illusion because there's nothing in here that would make it move downward. There's a fade and there's a scale. I guess scale is the thing that might be like optical illusionally making it look like it's moving downward. Actually, that time it looked like it actually started at the wrong point. Oh, Biodroxel! Thank you! Yes, you're right! That is part of it. It's gotta be part of it. Hold on. Let's fix that right now. So, let's make the pentagram center actually in the middle. The good suggestion. Biodroxel, excellent suggestion. Thank you! So, okay, it's 212 or 222. That's 111. 360. I guess it's just minus 222. Gives you 138. So, plus 360 should be 498 high. Move that to the top. Let's re-export it like that. Yeah. Don't help him. Don't help the man. Let the man struggle. It's the best part of this. Yeah, I was like, it's an optical illusion. Nope. Well, hopefully this actually works. It's probably part of the problem. Let's see if this is the whole problem, though. Layers and layers of problems. Yeah, you're right. You totally nailed it, dude. It's perfect now. Awesome. Fixed. No more struggling. It's just trying to carry the theme. We've got the meanest chat going already, ever. Might as well keep it. We'll slow down time a little bit just to make sure. Boom! Centered the whole time. Bam! Looks great. Okay, cool. Now I want to draw a cool pentagram, because this is like something I just grabbed from the internet. So let's draw something cool. Yeah, thumbs up. You just saved me like anywhere from 5 minutes to 2 hours. Sometimes shit takes that long. You're like, what the fuck is going on? I don't know. About to bang my head. I am banging my head against the wall for 2 hours. Trying to figure out the tiniest little thing. And it was that simple. It was just the freaking image. All right. Yes, my graphics tablet works today. This is amazing news already. All right, I want to do some kind of like, yeah, this is a additive lighting. So all these black pixels don't even count. So I want to do something similar to this. This art is a placeholder. Yeah. So the art you see right here is the art. This is a copy of the lightning boss, the last boss I worked on. Because I haven't even started the art for this boss. I'm working on only behaviors at first, the scripting of the AI first, and then I'll do the art. I like to do the scripting of the enemy first before I draw anything, because I want to make sure the boss is fun before I actually draw it and make it kind of permanent, you know? Because if it's not fun, then you can stop right then and be like, okay, how do I make this fun? What is it going to take to make this fun before I commit to some kind of look, you know? So this is just the art from the last boss. And I'm just, it's a placeholder. Yeah. And Boogie had a good suggestion earlier. Boogie was like, what about that boss you drew like 2 years ago for the final boss? And I'm like, that's a pretty good idea. Maybe phase two of this enemy. Like, you fight this boss, you beat him, and then he turns into something bigger, right? And, like, you can have half the screen fall away, so maybe you just can walk on pixels, or walk on these blocks down here at the bottom, but then the rest of it is all sky, and it's just some huge, giant boss. I've always wanted to make a boss, like, as big as the entire screen. I tried to do that with a couple of the bosses before, with the wall, and with the dragon, but, I think that would be a good use of space here, because this is kind of the outside of a tower. It's like a perfect place to have a giant boss. So this could be phase one, where you're fighting him kind of like this, and then phase two, you do the... Yeah, like the Medusa lady, exactly, yeah. So inspired by her. Probably drawn a little different, updated, but yeah. Okay, so... do I want some letters? If I do letters, I'm going to do the letters in the alien font of this game's world. I definitely want to see some pure circles here. I want to see some crisp lines, less of this gradient here in the middle. So here's the gradient version. Here's a pure version. Just a question. Oh, yeah. Yeah, your idea is have every boss come back at once. That's awesome. Well, I am so far, I'm just reusing a few bosses for the bottom floors of this tower. There's five floors of the tower, the first floor. First four, you have to like fight a couple bosses, but they're doubled up. So like you fight two of the drop bosses at once, which is actually really cool. But eventually I'm actually going to write some new bosses for all levels of the tower. What's up, social username? It looks tricky as hell to make. Video games are tricky as hell to make. You're right. Okay, so I'll start with this crisp circle on the outside. Do a duplicate of this. Make it smaller. So I can get a clean. Let's make this one red. Boss speed run. Yeah, it's totally a multi-boss dungeon already. Yeah, you weren't here with that stream. Let me show you. This is pretty cool. So this is kind of what this the tower is going to be like here. This is the final dungeon. It's a tower. You climb straight up it. And each level of the tower has a boss or multiple bosses at once, basically. But boss waves, yes. I'm liking this. I'm liking this a lot. Boss waves, multiple bosses, all of the bosses at once. I like it a lot. That's a cool idea. Two wall bosses? That'd be crazy. So yeah, you start climbing up the tower. You have to have Vel to even get in the tower. So like here's two of the drop bosses, which is actually two of my two moves. You know, hard sense. Debug I was trying to do earlier. I think I just bomb killed Bill. Oh, I froze myself! Why stop at two? Make it four. Four of them in this tiny room. Let's try it. Let's try it though. Why not? We'll see what happens. Why stop at two when you could have four? For only a dollar more. You'd be an idiot not to put four bosses in for only a dollar more. Yeah, dude, oh, it's nice. Thank you, man. Thank you. And don't worry. You don't need to worry about swearing here on this stream. Nice bomb. Here's four of them. They're all running exactly the same AI, which makes them start off exactly the same, but they get a little different. Oh my god, this is chaos because it's such a tiny room. Belle's scared. She's in the corner like... I'm already dead! That's a bug. Right now there's a bug where you can eat a cactus and then you don't stay alive. It's weird. Make it 10. Four walls. Oh, you were talking about the four walls. Well, hell, we're trying out four bosses here in this room anyways. This sounds fun. Why am I getting so worked by these guys? Like, they're taking so much damage. This is so hard. I'm putting it back at two. Maybe another level of this floor or of this dungeon would be good with four, but like it would need to be a bigger room. 10 is for casuals? Okay, alright, wait. Let's try 10. Let's try 10 or 20 actually. How many bosses can we fit in one room like this? Let's start with 10. This is a tiny room. What is this, super easy mode? This is supposed to be 10 bosses, but then only see 4. That is a... Oh no, they're there. They're there, they just all kind of like didn't fit, so they all spread out. Drop constant bombs. Oh my god. Okay, one more try. It's only 10. This is only 10. 4 billion bosses in the same room. Need to overflow it to feed yourself. Not too. Make it so it replicates up when you eat a cactus. Oh, no, that's a cool idea, Jonah. You eat a cactus and all of a sudden there's two bosses. I'm just button mashing at this point. I don't even have to see my character. Dropping bombs and eating cactuses. The cactuses aren't even working. Alright, 20 bosses. Here we go. There's 10. Let's try 20. They're really big, so that's why they don't spread out very well. Wizard boost pack? Probably 11. Totally. I know. This is like a 2013 model or something. Okay, they're starting. It looks like there's only four at first, but they'll spread out a bit. There's a lot of sound coming out of this thing right now. Let's turn it down to half. I'm floating on the sky, fighting 20 bosses. Okay, we'll try 50 next. Come on, Belle, you can do this. I'm just gonna stand here and let you do this, alright? You always wanted to get to F at 2:30 in the morning? Sorry. Sorry! I don't know, has she actually gotten one of them dead yet? Come on, Belle. Seriously. It's taking forever. Start using my top hat. And the ghost sword. Yeah, if my Mac does crash, the stream will definitely go offline. This is the definitely the joy of game development right here. This is the embodiment of the joy of game development. Putting 20 bosses in a tiny room just because you can. Just because somehow the collision detection engine allows them all to stand on each other. Press the add phone shortcut key. I don't have one of those yet. Can I show the FPS? Yeah. But it's only 8. But it's maxed out at 30 right now because I'm streaming. If I wasn't streaming, it would definitely be higher than 8. This should be at least one of the worlds. But look at this. This is gonna slow down totally well. There's so much debug data, it's like... It's definitely slowing down a lot. I think it slowed down more after I started the debug text. So, has one of them died yet? I can't tell. Wow. This is like super ultra slowdown now. I'm thinking they are leaving they're leaving a ton of particles on the top. Like whenever they drop one of their big bomb things, there's some particles that come from the ceiling. And there's also a ton of particles on the ground from all these dropped rocks. There's probably thousands of particles actually on the ground at this point. That's probably what's slowing it down the most. Chaos now. Can't even eat a cactus. Eat the cactus. There we go. Alright, so we're either gonna crash the game or beat this boss fight. Hopefully we don't crash the stream. Yeah, they don't disappear after a certain time. Because I never anticipated this. Yeah, there should be like a maximum number of sprites added or something. Come on. Sound like there's less of them? Oh, it crashed! We finally crashed the game! You never anticipated 20 bosses all dropping tons and tons and tons of rocks? Oh man, that was crazy. That was kind of intense. That was intense actually to experience that. See your game performing so badly. Totally, yes, we killed it. We killed it, and the stream is still going? Is the stream still going? Tell me it is. You guys are still chatting. I'm still here. Look at this. Whoa. Maximum number of entities reached. That's 8,000 entities it created. Yeah. ID 8192. It's like, boom. Can't do anymore. Well, that was an experience, huh? That was pretty cool. That was joyful. I'm going to put that back to 2 instead of 20 for now. And I'll put a note, you know, I should put a Trello note, like putting like a maximum number of sprites or something at least. So that doesn't ever happen in a real version of the game. I did like that though. I think there should be some kind of boss room where you do some crazy fight like that, where there's a ridiculous number of enemies. It just needs to somehow, the game needs to be smarter about how it manages its resources so it doesn't crash. But that's it. Any reason why it's capped at 8K? That's just the way I designed the entity component system. That it uses, it just allocates a block of memory for every one of the entity pointers it needs at the very beginning, so it never has to reallocate anything. So it's just, it makes it wicked fast that way, but it's also capped, right? So, but I would just need to make something so the code's just like, hey, if there's already 8,000 entities, just don't. In fact, if this were a release build, it wouldn't have crashed right there. It would have just stopped creating entities. The dead enemies do not get destroyed. Yeah, because they still have a sprite they leave behind. And that's technically what's going on with all those rocks that were on the ground. Every single one of those 20 bosses were dropping rocks all the time. And the rocks split open and then they just leave a rock sprite there the whole time. That's why the entities just maxed out and the sprites maxed out and all that. So it's really not that difficult to fix. It's just something else to do that I have to do after I finish the game, you know, after I finished all that. Kind of, yes, the entity pointers are all pooled. So the way that, yeah, it should actually pool all the entities as well, too, the components. But every entity is just a collection of components, and the components, the pointers to the components are all pooled together, but the components themselves are all located with new, which is not very optimal. I mean, I could write my own heap management or something like that, but yeah, exactly. You could delete dead entities when you reach a cap. That's a very very good way to do it, right? You just go through your list of entities you have already. Here's a bunch of dead entities that have been dead for a long time. Might as well just delete them. Yeah. So that was cool. So yeah, you get the point though, right? This tower dungeon is just full of a bunch of bosses, each floor. So there's that floor with the drop bosses. There's another floor with some blob bosses for now. These are all for now. I really want to design some new bosses actually to go in this on every floor of this dungeon. It'll be a lot of work, but that's That's what I have in mind. I don't know. I might have to just settle for just putting drop bosses and other bosses reusing, maybe with a different skin. But yeah, so there's that. There's like four floors inside the dungeon, and then the outside last floor is where you fight the final boss. But the rock isn't technically it is dead. Yes. So it's alive when it's falling through the sky, and then it hits the ground, breaks open, leaves a bomb, and dies. So technically it is a dead enemy. It's just looks like a rock. All right, so let's go back to the top floor of the tower. I think it's 11188. I'll work on this pentagram art. Yeah, you want to? That's so funny you say that, because this last boss is gonna have a sword. I know, but it's not gonna be as big as rock though. But I really want to create some actual, not bosses, but just regular enemies that fight with swords as well, and that are about the same size as you. So yeah, that's something I've wanted to see in this game too. Because you have a sword, why can't you fight other people with swords? Why can't there be some kind of interaction with the swords, like sword fighting? Yeah, I know. No one's going to know that you would delete totally. You wouldn't even notice. Yeah, it's just something I haven't done yet. One more little thing to make this game engine better. So I was going to take this and make it a different color. Put it here in the middle. Now do a cutout on this one. Wait, I want to duplicate this layer first. Oh, I think this actually would, nope, it didn't. Oh wait, that did. It did a cutout. The opposite of what I wanted though. Oops. Because I want to duplicate that layer and then select this layer and then delete from there. So we have a nice crisp thing there. And then we can get rid of that. So I'm thinking we're going to do some crisp pixel art here, not gradient style. I would know, but no one else would. You'd have to count them all first. Right? Who's going to do that? Who's going to take the time to count them all? Okay, let's do another circle in the middle and a pentagram shape. Actually, I really like this pentagram shape right here. I'm just going to color over the top of it. Oops. Let's get the line tool. I rarely use this tool, but this is the perfect thing for right now. Wait, oh, no, I don't need the line tool, just the pencil tool. Start there, draw a line to here, and then to here, and then to here. There we go. Pentagram shape. Okay, so we'll make it go under, wait, over here. Over, wait, under? Yeah, let's make it go under here. Whoa, risky. Over, under, over, under. Red Rover, send Boogie on over. I love that game. And then, okay, this goes over. Okay, cool. Now, do I want that to be bigger? Maybe. Run towards the light. Gets clothesline. It's the clotheslining game. Everybody gets clotheslined. All right, let's try this first. Oh man, if I screw it. I'm just going to see what this looks like first, like that. Because I'm thinking I might want this pentagram in the middle bigger. I thought the pentagram had the star upside down. For the right? The star upside down or not? That star is actually pretty well sized as it is, because when it gets all spread out and big at the very end, actually maybe it shouldn't be that big. Let's try a little less big. Take off one factor. One less, at least. That was pretty good actually, but I'm gonna try one more just to make sure that was about right. Proportions, when you make art, like, proportions are always the first most important thing. How big is it? How big should it be? How does it feel with it this big? That's a good quote. How does it feel with this big? That was actually kind of too small, so 5 it is. All right, I liked it. I thought I did. Oh yeah, here it is. Uh. Okay, we'll do another circle or oval around the outside. How can I make this gradient on top look more like pixel art? What if it was just move one pixel up? Like that, so I had a crisp. Yeah, I like that with a little more of a crisp line. Like that. Wait, is a pentagram up or down? Is that right? Oh, it is up. Wait, this one's down. This one's down. This one's up. Nobody knows which way is right. Yo, let's ask the internet. Pentagram, up or down? Which way does it go? Okay, so upside down. What's the difference between a point up pentagram and a point down? The point up is a symbol of Wicca. What's up? Welcome, new followers. It's Thirsto, it's poker time, Mentos. Ogre, is it Ogre or Orge? Orge should. Neverland Dreams. Dreaded Ronin. Forged Stet. Stealth. CBN. I am Sassafras. To most, the inverted pentacle represents Satanists, although the inverted pentacle is often mistaken as an evil symbol taken on by Satanists. It's true that Satanists use the inverted pentacle as a symbol for power, which it is, but in no way represents bad spirits. The right side up pentacle represents the goddess and the spirits of human beings. Upside down symbolizes the god and more developed power and higher witchcraft. Take your pick, I guess. Well, going with the plot of the video game, I should probably keep it up. I don't want to spoil too much, but let's see what it looks like going down. Hell, let's throw caution straight to the wind. Who needs caution anyways? Oh, it definitely looks more evil. Let's keep it like that for now. Make it sideways! What does it look like actually rotated? Can you actually do that? Whoa! Yeah, it feels so wrong. Whoa! Oh my god! Oh my god, where's warp dimension? Warp dimension. Oh, man, this is crazy. Yep, I didn't like any of that. Let's keep it like this. Okay, one more circle and we'll do some letters. And yes, it would just be a matter of perspective in terms of the game. Platformer Labs. And what's up, Platformer Labs? Hello? Alright, let's see if it's still looking good. Is that getting really pixelated? Not really that bad. Well, it is a little jaggy. Let me clean that up. What type of game are you making? It's like a game kind of like Zelda, man. The original Legend of Zelda. Let's see how this is feeling, though. With that new art and stuff. Things are good, Platformer Labs. Things are great. I just got off a nice vacation. I went to Burning Man 2 weeks ago. Kind of like eased into the next week. And now I'm here. 3 weeks after that. And life's awesome. Life is great. My creative tanks are recharged. Burning Man always does that. It's like you see other people's creativity so much there that it really inspires your own creativity. However creative you are, whatever kind of creative person you are, whatever you do with your creativity. She bounced. She did bounce that time. That was weird. Bouncing because she goes below the ground and back. Why is it so pixelated? It's 360 pixels big. Why does it look like that? It's being scaled up by 4. What? This is on this one pixel thing. This is a tick in pixel art. This is a giant image. This should be big enough. 360 pixels wide is almost the entire screen. Why is this like? Let's do true there. Look at that pixel. Coming 2016, is this still on track? Question marks above my head? Yes, update current information, please. I need to make a new trailer. It's been a long time since I made a trailer. Okay, that didn't help. I mean, it goes by so fast that you can totally tell that it's why is it so pixelated? Is anyone else seeing this? It's like, it's not that pixelated in the image, is it? Oh, is it messing it up in Texture Packer? This isn't a different kind of sprite sheet. 32. You're gonna make a trailer? Nice. Is this being scaled? Scale 1. All right. I'm gonna make this scale 1 and no scaling going on, because I'm curious as to why it looks so. Looks the way it does. Yeah, that is messed up. That image right there should be covering the entire screen, how big it is. And it's obviously not. Why? What? Is it scaling? No. This says it's 512 by 512? What? Gods. Oh, here's the problem. Scaling to 0.25. Yeah, so it is a quarter of how big it's supposed to be. Oh, I was like, I thought I was drawing this right. It was basically scaling it down to a quarter of the size. And it's doing that for every single one of these other sprites here that look like this and this and this and this. So what I should do is take every one of these sprites here and make them a quarter of the size, and then make this scaling variant just the same as it was, to 1.0. Okay. Yeah, no. I don't want to scale it up. I want to scale it down. So all these are scaled down, then put the scale back to how it was. This is going to take a minute to fix all this. But it'll make it so this art is actually accurate and it looks good. All right, let's do this. Okay, start with this. Scaling variance, 1. There, now the image is 2048 by 2048. Could keep all these images the way they are, but then it's going to make a lot of the game's art really freaking crazy. Actually, that's a smarter idea, though. Just to scale it in the code. Yeah, I'm gonna scale it in the code. Okay, everywhere that I use circle.ping. Wait, first of all, let's verify that this even works. So if I put this function back how it was and then run this, the pentagram should look a lot better. And if it does, if it still looks really pixelated, then something's still wrong. Yeah, there we go. Looks so much better. Oh, the background clouds are one example of something that uses. Yeah, that's so much better. Oh. Boom. Okay. So some things are going to be scaled, some things I'll scale in code, some things I'll scale outside of code. All right, fastest way to do this is going to be with the mouse, not the graphics tablet. I'll start with triangle big, because I think I only use that in one place. Does it deal damage? Yeah, this thing deals damage. It's supposed to deal a lot of damage, but it's not dealing enough yet. Yeah, so there's only one place that uses this here, explosion triangle, which is when you drop one of your super bombs. So I'm gonna go put the player like back to 0, 0, 188. Start using some super bombs and make sure the art for the super bomb looks good. I'll either scale it there in the code or scale it back in the sprite sheet. There, circle big thin is another one of those pieces of art. It looks weird now. Okay, so I'm dropping this. Well, let's just save here. Does look cleaner. All right, cool. We can keep it like that then. So the explosion triangle Gets scaled up to 10.8. So yeah, this is the scale ratio. And so it used to start at 0.25. Now it's going to be 0.25 times 0.25. And same thing here, we're going to 10.0 times, well, that would be 2.5. And this is 2.5 times scale ratio. So I have a cleaner, it's a cleaner art. Man, that was a big mistake to have that scale ratio there. I'm glad I found this, because every one of those pixel art effects was, it was really like dirtying up the pixels. It was just scaling them down to 0.25 and scaling them back up in the code. So you get a lot of jaggedy pixels that way. It's not intentional art. It's unintentional art. Unintentional bad looking stuff. There, so that looks a lot cleaner. Yay! So next we'll do circle big thin maybe. This one using a lot of places. This actually could be smaller. Because I don't ever really use big. But I might in the future. Okay, it's probably best to. You think the starting triangle is too big? Okay, let me see it in slow-mo. That's kind of the way I aesthetically planned it if from the beginning to be like that. But I can try it a little smaller. Still good. I like it like that. It's cool. Maybe it could go a little. It needs to go a little further down, though. You did the parallax effect already? Nice. Yeah, nice, Arcane. I think that looks awesome. Right? Don't you think so? It adds like a really, really nice effect to this whole thing. I think it'll really wow him too. Thumbs up, dude. I think it looks cool. I wonder what other people think. Definite. Juicy. Juicy. About right. Maybe 7 actually would be right. 7 or 6. It's just 6. Yeah, Arcane, nice, man. Nice. Yeah, right? Hey, dude, I'm impressed you did that fast. Parallax is not easy. Yeah, that was right. Okay, cool. Enough messing with that. That's great. I want to go circle big thin. There's a lot of places that use that. I want to decide whether I'm going to change it in the art or change it in the code. What's this first one? Scan location? Oh, that's where Jib has a little circle where he's like, oh, you can scan right here. Same thing with, this item glow. Yeah, I feel like I could make this half the size at least. Because I'm using it mostly for small stuff. But am I ever going to use this for something huge? Probably not. And I think it would actually help this whole sprite sheet to pack into half the size if I just made this a little smaller. Okay, let's do it. Circle big thin. It's currently 720. If I make it 360, I think it should really gel the whole. Everything should look a little better. Image size 360. And hopefully that did not ruin or make anything too jagged. I don't think so. Nice. So you already got jQuery? Sweet. Yeah. Right on. Cool. Yeah, it already is. It is already a different color. Jib scan is white, and then the other scans are colored. Less opaque? Maybe I'll make it less opaque. Let's try that out. All right, does that make this? Yeah, it did. Nice. It made this sprite sheet half the size. That's good. Save that. And then expanding circle is now going to be not a quarter, but a half the scale. It starts it. Oh, it immediately scales through this. The item glow. We already have an item on the ground here, so this should work. Yeah, you're right. You're totally right. There are some sprites that have theirs as white as well. A lot of them actually have theirs as white. That's a good point. Because it should be clear that this is an item and this is somewhere you can scan. Because they both kind of have, I mean, there, that's good. See, that one's red, because that item is red. That looks good though. It's the right size. Okay, let's go somewhere where we can get jib on the screen. Oh wait, first, let's just make sure this, here we're at this code. Let's make it the right size. All right, so we need jib. We need like Z 720. Maybe making it faster. Help to make it look like a different effect right away. It fades from, well, it fades in, and then it stays that way. No, wait, it fades back to, okay, it does, well, oh, it fades out the whole time. It fades out, fades out, fades out. Ah, see, it still looks about like the same. I mean, even though they are, it's a faster animation right now, I'm not sure that it's actually help to make it any clearer though. Jib, come here dude, Jib. It's like a ripple. And I could try it less opaque. Try no scaling. Yeah. That was better actually with faster. So let's try middle between those two speeds and then sure, let's try no scaling. Maybe it's just always the max. Scale by 1.6 times 0.075. Oh hell, we could just put that in here. I guess I could do like a dotted line too, or maybe a different, a thicker circle, or. Actually, I'm gonna try the scaling going the opposite way. So scale starting big and then going smaller. Oh my god, I love the phi ratio. 1.618 and 0.618. The relationship between those two numbers is so great. There you go, that's a lot different. Buongiorno! What's up, James? And one last thing I want to do to that is to make the scan location a little bit higher. Where is it? Where the hell is this position? Oh, it's a child of the sprite, so we want to do like vec2 0. And then this is gonna be like the size of the entity usually, but usually you're looking at more like small enemies and stuff. And we have no idea how big the entity was anyways. So yeah, let's just do something like 6. Or block size, half a block size. You working on your first boss? Nice, man. Remind me what game you're making? You're working on? I can't remember if we talked about this already or not. Oh, that's a little too far. Yeah, this kind of says, come get me, come scan me. I am a position you would like to scan. Come on, Jib, do it. Do it, Jib. Go. Yeah, Jib. Woo, Jibby! Oh, it's the first time? Oh, all right, man. What game were you working on? Link Blocks. Blocks. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like this for now. It's good. Okay, so next image I gotta fix in this whole thing here. Let's try circle. Circle that ping. Pike and shot. Ooh, nice arc, man. Oh, sweet. Sweet! I've never seen a game like this. Good job, man. I love it. I love the pixel art. I like this concept, too. This is a sweet concept. So, if I'm getting this right, your concept is kind of like that you're forming like a little mini army and you're having like attacks and stuff. Or like, you know, it makes me think of this one game I played on Sega Genesis a long time ago. What was it? It was such a rad game. Where you form teams and then you kind of like arrange them and you do these battles and stuff. I forget what it was called though. And you could like power up each one of the characters and stuff. Oh, but it controls like a shoot 'em up. Oh, sweet. Nice, man. I like your concept. It seems really original to me. Okay. Kovarni, yes, I'm alive. General Chaos, was that it? That doesn't sound right. There was something else on Sega Genesis where you kind of like controlled. No, yeah, it wasn't this one. Yeah, it wasn't this one, but This looks cool too. I never played this. I love the 16-bit era. Yeah, totally. Okay, so I gotta get these other ones in, like explosion oval, that's when you drop a bomb. Circle is now, needs to be a quarter of this size. Let's do a scale ratio here too. Los comillos. Sweet. Are those cats or wolves? They look like cats. He's got like an army of cats. But wait, oh, they are wolves. Oh, okay. I thought they were cats at first. I was like, they're cats. That's kind of funnier with cats, but like, I see the wolves now. I totally see the wolves. They kind of look like, coyotes. Coyotes. Because coyotes kind of got like their rear ends are kind of lower, you know? They're meant to be wolves. All right. I thought they're. Yeah. That guy looks cool though. Maybe they're lions. They could be a lot of things. It's pixel art. This looks like a fish. It can be anything. Okay, explosion oval. I just drop a bomb. We'll see that. Oh, wait. I want to do one more thing. Turn off this AI system thing where it tracks Z. I don't need to track Z anymore. Obviously, it's mouses. whatever it is, it's a cool concept for an enemy. Or a hero. I'm not sure what. Is that a hero or an enemy? And so what are the bosses going to be like in your game? Fading in anymore. Set scale, set opacity, fade, duration, fade. Oh, fades to white at the end. I think that's supposed to be zero. And then this is a scale to remove self. Okay. Oh, he is the boss. Nice, it's a goblin raid. Oh, so he's a goblin. He's a goblin and he has a bunch of wolves. Oh yeah, I see a goblin. It's cool. I like how they're circling him. I like how they're just, he's like, it's his pack of wolves. Thank you. Oh, I see why you can't see it phase, because it never, it always is that big. Okay, I can dial that in further later. Next, dust. Dust uses either pixel or circle, square, set opacity, scale 0.01. Which you would think would be pretty small, but you never know. Scale 2, here's the scale 2, move by, fade. Okay, so the scale, if you're square, it goes to 2.0, otherwise it goes to 0.05, this should be 0.025. Wait. Times a quarter. Yeah. Okay, that's dust. So if I just run around in the dirt, it will kick up some dust. You got a new one, some necromancer who rides a dinosaur skeleton? Nice. And then a sea creature. Sweet, man. Nice, I'm liking it. Thanks, man. Yeah, thanks for saying you like the rain. Cheers. There's still some stuff I got left to do with this rain. Right now, the one problem with the rain is if you see it fall right here, like on these rocks or whatever, it's gonna look like it hit the ground, not the rocks. So I need to make the rain falling in 3D. So there's still some work left to do to make this rain better. Okay, so if I just kick up, yeah, that's looking right. That's how big the dust used to be. Nice. Okay, so dust is cool. Regular bombs are cool. Don't need that. Interfaces, current button indicator. Oh, that's for when you're remapping controls. And how big is it? Scale, let's make that a quarter. And does it scale? No, it just fades. Oh, it does scale. But it scales by, so that's fine if it starts at a bigger. Let's just make sure that worked. I'm going to copy and back up my saves. And run the game and reset my controls. Make sure that still looks good. Lilu in the fifth element. You like this? Jonah likes the snow. So there's like five kinds of rain, and then there's snow, and then there's regular sunshine. Those are just all pretty easy weather mechanics to do. And there's a whole day-night cycle. I don't know if you guys knew this, but there's a day-night cycle. I'll turn it really fast so you can see this really quick. Make the day length really short. So here's the day-night cycle. I like the game right about there, and like in the afternoon and the early morning where you can see the long shadows and everything's casting a nice... It's like, it really makes the game feel more 3D when you see those shadows cast like that. But, you know... This whole day-night cycle thing is actually pretty cool in general, I think. Adds a nice real element to the game. And then some secrets you can only activate at night, stuff like that. X and A, nice. You heard there's a mini bot? You heard. Yeah, there'll be tons of stuff like that once the game's all done. Once the Easter eggs are finally in there. I just want to reset my controls, that's all. Yeah, that's fine. Size of that little circle is exactly how it should be. Everything is... This is A. B. C. Okay, that's another one done. I think that's it. Fear gas. Oh, fear gas also is the circle. Ooh, we got to check this. I think that needs to be scaled 0.25. Okay, so we got to go to the last, the wall boss. Where is he at? I think that's dungeon 7. Yeah. With the dust kickup, is there any plans to have it changed based on if it's raining or snowing? Oh! Mutinous, that's a good suggestion. That's a really good detailed suggestion. I should add that to my Trello list. Thank you. Thank you for suggesting that. Sometimes the dust probably shouldn't even be there. Like if it's raining really hard, it's not going to kick up dust. Yeah, great suggestion. That's a little detail that will make a big difference. All right, Kovarni, good night, man. Mayo. Is it Mayo or Mayo? Yeah, I'm coding in C++. That's this language. Okay, so this should be dungeon 7. Now we need to go find the boss here in this dungeon and make sure he works with... I think the boss is up straight up to the right. Oh yeah, here it is. Okay, so he's gonna kick up some fear gas stuff, and I think this fear gas is... I think it's gonna need to be scaled a lot smaller. Yeah, it's huge. Totally. Okay, so I think if I just make this scale here, 0.25. It snows in the desert. Oh, you're right. If it was raining really hard, it would just look like water splashing. Good point. Very good point. Yeah, okay, so that circle is now right. Okay. I love this boss. I just wanna fight it. Cause it's like fighting it's up, right? Let's go great. Fight this guy. I think I have the Viper chip right now, which should make this boss fight a lot easier. Yeah. It's a total button mashing fight so far. I need to give this guy a few more attacks and stuff. Make it so some of the eyes can attack you and some of them don't, so that it's a little bit more interesting of a fight. At this point, it's just too button mashing. Yeah, so that was easy that time with the Viper chip. Oh, whoa, the item glow. Yeah, that's just huge now. Oh, some of these effects are actually gonna be pretty... Huh. Proton, what's up, Proton? Thanks. What's up, Fox Chugs? The Doom Wall? Yeah, there's a lot of wall bosses in video games. Thanks, Proton. Cheers. I'm thinking, so what I'm doing right now, guys, is I'm working on the all these different... These are big effects. They're actually quite big for pixel art. Like especially that triangle right there is huge. And they were a quarter of the size. I really should make this a quarter of the size of the rest of these even. Just all of these a quarter because the way textures work and stuff like that, if you're using huge textures, it's just slower for the GPU and stuff. So I think I'm gonna do that for the remaining sprites here. So circle, I left big so that I could do some bigger art, especially like the huge circular explosion animation, but the rest of these don't need to be this big. Wait, I already made circle big, thin, half the size. So I should make just the rest of them. So let's start with, I already fixed circle as well though. So let's do oval gradient. Thanks, Fox. Okay, so this one's done. Here's the pentagram I was working on that triggered all this. We need circle gradient, circle medium, oval gradient, spiral gradient. This one is, I don't know. Why can't you do 0.25%? What's wrong with this? 360. Thank you, It's Remax. I appreciate that. Where did I learn programming? I learned programming from books. You really want to develop any games? That's cool, man. The engine I'm using is called Cocos 2DX. Cocos 2DX. It's a C++ game engine. What kind of games do you want to make? Because engine choice is pretty important for what kind of games you're going to make. And also, what kind of platforms do you want to release your games on? That's also a really important thing for choosing what engine you're going to use. Okay, if this had a background, does that look good? Oh, yeah. I guess this looks okay. That's it before. It's like really, really gradient-y. I think it still looks pretty good. Didn't like lose too much quality or whatever by making it a little smaller. Spiral gradient. Oh, why do I have two of them? Oh, which one's what? Why do I have two of those? Oh man, this is tough to see. Okay, so that one is like spiraling clockwise. Maybe this one's just spiraling counterclockwise or something. Oh no, it is different looking. Mostly PC, maybe Xbox. You love platformers and roguelikes, like Meat Boy, Binding of Isaac is your favorite games. Nice, the indie game movie inspired you. That's cool. Did you watch indie game The Afterlife, or what's it called? The Afterlife, the after something. There's a follow-up movie to indie game, so if you should see that too. Definitely worth seeing. It's got a lot more of Edmund McMillan's thoughts. I really love Edmund McMillan too. He's a super cool guy. I really feel like if I met him, I'd be like, this guy, I really get this guy. He's cool. If you're into making PC games and Xbox, well, look, I don't know. You could use Unity and probably do really well with that. It kind of depends on your type of style of making games. Like maybe if you just wanted to make kind of like, I don't know, you'll find the engine you want to use. You'll find it. So this spiral is different. That spiral has like some... Oh, this is a tighter spiral here. Okay, I got it. And these are exported at 360. So we want these spirals. I guess I probably have one of them and then another. Like there's, oh, because I got them both on? Yeah, wait, what? Yeah, no, wait. There's one. Yeah, zero and one. What's this one and a half? Oh, that one and a half and two I never used. Okay, so zero, simple. Oh, Life After, not Afterlife. Yeah, the sequel. Sweet. So you watched it. Nice. Yeah, you're welcome, man. You're welcome. Welcome to making games. Share your progress. Tell me how you're going. Tell me how your go of it goes. This is Spiral Gradient 0. Overwrite that. And then this one is 1. Okay, so that's a quarter the size. No need to mess with any of the code on that one. Oval gradient here is same thing. This is what, 360 wide. It's gonna need to be 90 wide. Let's make sure it didn't like degrade it too much by scaling. See, that looks okay. This oval gradient is used a lot in the cloud textures. So that's why I'm making sure to scale this texture down rather than doing it in code, because this is really gonna help the shaders perform better. Oval gradient, circle medium. See this, I'm not even sure I'm even using this. Yes, it's not even used once. Well, there's no fear then of changing it. So just scale it. No need to worry. 90, like this jaggedy pixels, doesn't really matter. Besides, it's not really that jaggedy. Okay, circle medium done. Okay, circle gradient. Did I change that one? Nope. I do believe that's all. And are they smaller now? Not really. That triangle is still huge. And the circle big thin doesn't need to be that big. Yeah, that really makes this whole sprite sheet better. And then I think these other two should be a little smaller too. So triangle big. Maybe we can make this scale just half. So those were half. I think that means this should be 5. We'll check that. And then these other two. Circle big thin. And circle. Circle. This one I think I'm gonna compromise and just do. Wait. I think I was supposed to be, is that 1.5? 0.3 now. I don't know. Too many things at once. Okay, all in all, the spreadsheet is now a lot smaller. And it still has the pentagram. Okay, so we're good here. Let's get that compiling. It's Remax. How far away from completion? Oh man, that's a good question. I can't really give you an accurate answer there. It's hard to say. I mean, I'm very close to the game being mostly content complete. This is the last boss. I'm working on the very final boss and the final dungeon, which means the game will be mostly content complete at that point, but there's so many little things I'll be doing after that. Lots of minor content to be added. Secrets to be added, Easter eggs, more NPCs, more enemies, and all of that is like gonna take an undetermined amount of time. I have no idea. You know, the game was supposed to be released this year, and now it's like getting so late in the year that, you know. Huh, all right, this is a lot of work just to, like, update all these, but it was pretty important stuff that had to be changed. I hope I got, that's fear gas as well. Shit, a lot of these. I think I did all these right. I hope I did all these right. We'll check them all. I gotta take a break soon. It's probably been streaming for a while. It's a long stream. Feels like a long stream. Probably because I was on vacation last week and the week before. Just getting back into the swing of things. Okay, let's make sure this big circle this guy drops is cool. The right size. Yes, it's the right size. I did the math right there. Woo! Okay, kicking up some dust. The dust kick up is half too small. Yeah, the dust is wrong. Is that this one? Here we go. Dust. Set scale, and then scale 2. Oh, I was supposed to scale to 0.5 there. Yeah, so this game is 2 years into the... Well, almost 2 years into the making at this point. Um... not sure how much longer it will go, but it's not going to go another 2 years for sure. It's going to go a lot less than that. The game is like around 80% complete. I don't know. It's funny how in game development, you get your game about 80% complete or so, and then the last 20% takes almost as long as the first 80%. Because there's so much time spent in refinement, and polishing, and perfecting, and getting rid of bugs, and adding little things that you didn't think of for the first 2 years of making it, you know? You've seen indie game, you know how it goes. Okay, so those dust particles are now looking about the right size. Bombs, super bombs, make sure both of those work. And then item drops. Yeah, that triangle's still good. Oh, okay, we got some, the item spots are just twice too small. But that was good. Okay, item drop. Mutinous. Yeah, I've heard about Terraria. Terraria is a huge success story. They've got like 7 million sales for their game. I haven't played it. I haven't really heard that much about it, but I know that it's done really well. And yeah, they've been releasing extra content for years, huh? Well, that's definitely that kind of game, right? Where you can keep on adding content to it. Scan location. 0.15, so I made this. So yeah, it does need to be 0.3. And then this one is item glow. I think this probably needs to be 3 as well. Yeah, 7 million sales. That's like, that could be up to $70 million in profit, I think, with the price of their game. And it's going to be a lot less than that because of taxes and Steam's cut and paying out to however many developers are on their team and all that kind of stuff. But it's definitely made, that game has probably made a few millionaires, that's for sure. So Mutinous, what do you like about Terraria? What's tell me about it from your perspective. Okay, I think all those are good now. Alright, getting back to the boss I was freaking working on. Let's turn that to there. This. Wow, we'll keep that position and then go back here. Need to turn Vel back on. How long have I been streaming? I'm getting tired. My voice is... Oh my god, it's been streaming for 2.5 hours. Whoa. Okay, I gotta get going here. But let me recap. Let me do a little recap, eh? A recapping of all the capping that's gone on today. Oops. Whoops! It should be 11188. Why was that not 11? That was 001888. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yes! Alright! That art looks way better! The pentagram looks really, really crisp and clean. Even when it scales pretty big, it's looking really good. Oh, it's scaling too big now, maybe. Yeah, so just a recap, though. What I'm working on here is the final boss of Songbringer. And you're going to fight this boss twice. You fight four bosses before you even get here, and in this same dungeon, it's just a big old boss fight. Bosses. But then you get to this final boss, and so what I'm working on here is just the behaviors at first. I'm working on making sure this boss is fun first. This is not what this boss will look like. I just stole the art from the last boss I worked on and just reused it just so I could get something started so that I could create some behaviors first. I'm working on like all the attacks of this boss just to make sure it's all fun. So I've only got one attack so far where he is gonna fly up off the screen and then slam back down on the screen and just do some huge explosion type thing. So I'm working on this little pentagram art that shows up when he does that slam down. So that's what I'm working on today, what was done today. That's some of the best elements of Sandbox. Side-scrolling combat, some platforming for good measure. Yeah, it's on my wish list. I should definitely play Terraria. Yeah. Right now I'm playing Ori and the Blind Forest. I'm catching up on lots of games that I haven't played yet. So, alright guys. Well, thanks for watching. I appreciate everybody and all your support. Constant support. It's so great to I'm really glad that I started a live stream for this video game because it's just nice to know that there's other people out there that just even know what this game is, you know? It sucks to make a game in your closet and not tell anybody about it, because sometimes no one ever does find out about it. So I made a pretty good decision by starting to share this game day by day by day by day. So, whatever. I'm appreciative of you guys, that's all I'm trying to say. And we'll catch you next time. Next stream will probably be tomorrow, and I'm always streaming about this time. So, cheers everybody, see ya!